Hey, I'm Clint Garrett, ACE Networker, and today we're going to talk about the Cisco Hierarchical Model. Now, I'm going to begin this series because we're going to move beyond Network Plus because it's important to you, especially whether you have taken the Network Plus certification exam and passed it or not, or whether you're still waiting to take it, it doesn't matter because you're going to want to, at some point in your own personal networking career or business, you're going to want to move forward. And Cisco certifications are going to be probably the next logical step for you, CCNA, CCNP. So you're going to need to understand the Cisco hierarchical model, but you'll need to understand it more for just learning about Cisco products. You'll need to know it for computer networking in general. We're going to get into the Cisco hierarchical model, so stay tuned. To thoroughly understand computer networks, whether you're designing them, troubleshooting them, adding to them, or trying to secure them, you need to know about the Cisco hierarchical model. Now, we've all dealt with hierarchy and levels of hierarchy in our lives. When we were younger, if we had older siblings, we had to deal with the oldest sibling or siblings being favored sometimes more, or with them getting to experience growing up and getting older and being able to do things before we did. Just as well to have any civility in a civilized society and any success as a group of people. We have to have different hierarchies to keep things organized and to prevent anarchy from happening. We have to have law enforcement in case there are those that choose to break the law and hurt or take from others. We have to have hierarchy within business organizations. If you want a raise, you can't just ask someone lower on the hierarchical level than you. You have to ask a boss or a supervisor. So hierarchy helps us keep things organized and running efficiently. It's no different in the computer networking world. And Cisco sort of set the standard for how they define a computer network hierarchy. And this hierarchy helps you when you're trying to determine where you need the most security on a network or where certain devices connect and work the best on a network. So let's get straight to the Cisco hierarchical model. Now, the Cisco hierarchical model is more of a logical model than a defined physical layout model. It's a way to logically define your network or a network to determine where priorities need to be placed, again, when it comes to security and certain types of equipment, routers, switches, firewalls, end-user devices, etc. There are three layers in the Cisco hierarchical model. The core layer, sometimes called the backbone, the distribution layer, also called the routing layer, and the access layer, or sometimes called the switching layer. There are different responsibilities you'll find at each layer of this model. And again, it's logical and not necessarily physical components. Much like the OSI model that has seven logical layers, there are multiple protocols, and sometimes some of those protocols map to more than one layer of the OSI model. It's very similar in the Cisco hierarchical model. You may have many devices in one layer, and sometimes only one device or single device in a layer. So before we proceed, just remember the definition of the layers is logical and not physical. The first layer is the core layer, or what many refer to as the backbone of a network. The core layer defines the literal core of a network. This is the layer that is responsible for transporting the majority of the traffic on a network and is the layer whose physical components are connected to everything peripheral on the network, either directly or, in most cases, indirectly. The core layer is not only responsible for transporting large amounts of traffic, but transporting that traffic as quickly and reliably as possible. Traffic transported on the core layer of a network is common to the majority of users on that network. Now, I'll get into this in just a couple minutes, but user data is processed at the distribution layer, and this core layer gets the requests forwarded to it by that distribution layer when they're needed. If the core layer or backbone has any issues with functionality or connectivity, every single user on the network can be affected. In a majority of cases, the core layer is where you'll implement things like fault tolerance. Also, since large volumes of traffic are seen at the core layer, speed and latency become extremely important here. Again, the core layer gets referred to as the backbone of a network because it's so vitally important to the life, functionality, and efficiency of the computer network. The second layer is the distribution layer. It's also called the routing layer, and over the years, the distribution layer has been referred to as the work group layer. It is the communication between the core layer and the access layer, which I'll talk about in just a few seconds. The distribution layer provides routing, filtering, WAN, can access and determines how packets can access the core layer if they need to. The distribution layer has to determine the fastest way network service requests are handled. After the distribution layer determines the best path, it forwards the request to the core layer. Again, if it needs to. The core layer would then forward the request to the correct service. Most policies are implemented at the distribution layer. These are things like routing, access lists, packet filtering, queuing, security and network policies, address translation, and firewalls, redistribution between routing protocols, VLANs, and defining broadcast and multicast domains. And this leads us to the third layer, the access layer. This is the third layer in the Cisco hierarchical model. The access layer essentially controls the user and workgroup access to the internet work resources on a computer network. The access layer is often referred to as the desktop layer or the switching layer. The network resources most of the users will need will be available locally on a network and handled by this access layer. But again, the distribution layer that we just talked about handles any traffic for remote services. Some of the more common functions you'll see at the access layer on a computer network are continued access control and policies, creation of separate collision domains, better known as segmentation, and workgroup connectivity into the distribution layer. So those are the three layers of the Cisco hierarchical model, and again, you'll need to know this as you progress in your own networking career and or business in the future. This video and other future videos is moving toward a CCNA or CCNP certification, obviously because it's more Cisco focused. But these will be good things to know beyond Network Plus level certification, and they will in fact help you on studying for Network Plus. Because if you know these things ahead of time, even before you go in and take your Network Plus, you're going to be that much more ahead of the game. So that's the three-layered Cisco hierarchical model, and I will see you on the next video. Are you ready?